I've been meaning to have a word with you about Hetherington. He never damn well knocks before he comes.
Usual today, madam?
No. I think I'll have one extra today, please.
Charlie! Come on! Well, at least this time, nurse, I haven't left anything in the patient. Nurse?
Of life.
No.
What a pity. I've forgotten them.
Here we are, sir. Room 24. One of our most pleasant, if I may say so.
Oh, yes. Very nice, very nice. Just the job.
Shall I get the porter to bring up the rest of your luggage, sir?
Hello, this is all I have.
Oh, I see. Well, will you be requiring tea in the morning?
No, actually, I won't be staying the night. That is the Inland Revenue Building over there, is it?
Hmm? Oh, that. Yes, yes, indeed it is.
Good gracious.
Yeah.
I say, you don't mean you're actually going to shoot one of Her Majesty's tax inspectors from this hotel?
Well, I would have thought that was obvious.
In that case, may I suggest room 36? You'll have a much better view from there.
Haven't much longer to go.
Don't say that, my dear.
No, but it's true. Darling, before I go, there are some confessions I must make. You remember your pay package you thought you lost last month? Well, darling, you didn't lose it. I stole it. And I used the money for a dirty weekend in Brighton with my best friend, George. And it was I who sent your mistress away. It was also I who reported your income tax evasion to the Inland Revenue. Oh, my darling, can you ever forgive me?
Of course, my dear. Please don't worry about it. Because I have a confession to make, too. I'm the one that poisoned you.
Yes. Just coming up to 9 o'clock.
God, not much longer then.
You seem to be in a bit of a nervous state.
Nervous state? Should have seen me before I took the tranquilizers.
It's only a driving test.
Look at that traffic out there. You've got to go in amongst that, you know.
Yeah, still, we've all got to start, haven't we? Ah, we'll soon get used to it.
Now, where's my rabbit's foot? You see my rabbit's foot anywhere? Yeah. Oh. There it is. These are great help. Oh, my God. Oh, dear. Doesn't seem to be your day, does it? Do you know, if I were you, I'd just pack up and go home. No, you're in no fit state to be on the road.
Mr. Chalmers?
Yes, I'm here.
OK, Rutland. He's all yours, taken away.
Mr. Chalmers, I hope you've had a lot of lessons, because this driving can be very dangerous.
Driving instructor, you are.
Very good, Mr. Scrooge. Yeah. So all those driving lessons I gave you finally paid off, eh?
Yeah. That means I can drive any car I like now, doesn't it?
Right. You'll have to get yourself a car.
That's right. Here. I think I'll have this one.
Oi! Yeah, what do you think you're doing? Here, you! Hey! 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 Stop! That's my car!
Excuse me.
Yes, madam.
Miss.
Yes, miss.
Are you the gentleman in charge of this test centre?
I am. Can I help you?
I've heard that there's one of your examiners who won't pass a woman driver unless she lets him have his way with her.
Well, I don't know whether it's true or not, miss, but if you can point him out to me, I'll have him.
No, you point him out to me, and I'll have him.
Oh, beg your pardon.
He's a nice, distinguished gentleman like you.
Oh, I am he.
My name's Harris. I'm the examiner appointed to conduct your test.
Oh, excellent. Capital.
I assume you've received the necessary instruction to take the test?
All guidance comes from on high.
What I really meant was driving lessons.
Oh, indeed, yes. I had a half an hour with the bishop's wife only last week.
Half an hour? Do you mean that's all you've had?
Well, that is all I require. After all, when one is a servant of the church, one learns to rely upon it in all things. As the good book says, faith can move mountains.
I only hope you can drive a car through Clapham Broadway.
Fear not, my son. Put your trust in the good shepherd, who is ever watchful of his flock.
Very good. For an attractive young lady, you surprised me. You drove like a man.
Oh, thank you.
Apart from your two big boobs. Well, first of all, look how you reacted when that policeman suddenly put his hand up.
Oh, you are awful. But I like you. Let me introduce myself. I am Zed from Munich.
Guten Morgen, mein Herr. I am B from Bethnal Green.
You were not followed?
I had a tail, but I lost it on the inner circle.
CID?
Special branch. What happened to my last contact?
You mean Q from Amsterdam?
Yes.
This is a lucrative but dangerous game we are playing, my friends.
Poor old Q.
Yes, it was the most brutal thing I have ever seen. He died at the hands of a fiend.
Oh, my God. Who did it?
I did.
My mob's a hard lot, but you...
We Germans play for keeps, my friend.
Poor old Q. I liked him. He was a real mate of mine, was Q.
Yes, and because I am a romantic nature, I have brought you something to remember him by.
Oh, thank you very, very much indeed. That's very kind of you. I appreciate that, Zed, very much. Oh, what is it?
One of his ears. And now, my friends, we have been ordered to carry out your operation tomorrow night.
I just wanted to make sure the bench wasn't bugged. Tomorrow night, eh? Blimey, that don't give us much time. What's the target?
It is a big one.
How big?
You've heard of the Bank of England?
The Bank of England!
Try and keep cool, my friend. Keep cool.
I don't like it, Zed. I don't like it at all. The Bank of England, ain't they? They got soldiers there, you know, with dirty great bayonets. I don't want one of them up my...
Everything has been thought of. Your rear will be fully protected.
Oh, no, it's too dangerous. I won't do it.
You imbecile. Do you realize there's 300 million pounds worth of gold in there and it is your job to get it out?
It's like a powerhouse. Electric doors, poison gas, machine guns. How am I going to get in there? Go on.
There's a small window down the side street. You must climb in there.
Well, what's through there, then? Where's it go to?
You've heard of the governor of the Bank of England?
Yes.
It is his private cloakroom.
Well, I can't go in the governor's car, see? Suppose he came in a farmy. What would I say? I feel a fool.
Pick up a bucket and mop and say that you hope everything is to his satisfaction. And you might seize the opportunity of asking him the direction to the gold vaults.
I won't do it. I won't do it.
I'm afraid you will, my friend. Not only is it the organization that is concerned, you will also have to account to the Mafia.
Oh, my God. You've ruined it all, you blinking foreigners. It's all right before you lot got over here. We used to do a nice, quiet little train robbery. A bit of smash and grab. Little tickle here, little tickle there.
So, this is your so-called Dunkirk spirit, huh? Must I remind you what happened to your friend Q?
May he rest in peace.
He is resting in pieces. How would you like one of your ears to be sent back to your wife?
Go on, cut me. I don't care. Kill me, kill me, cut me. Can't finish with you. You murdering swine. I don't care what you do to me anymore.
Hey! You know what the time is? Stretching the old lunch hour a bit, aren't you? It's only 2:05.
Is it really, Charlie?
It's amazing how time flies when you're enjoying yourself.
Yeah. Here we are.
Hey! Oh, I really enjoyed that today,
yeah,
Ted.
Yeah, so did I. Yeah, that German's a real swine, isn't he?
Yeah, not at all. Hey, that reminds me, I've been the coward for the last 5 days running.
Yeah.
About time I was the chief, isn't it?
Yeah, well, fair enough. All right, your turn this time.
All right, I'll tell you what tomorrow. What? I'll be a Chinaman. Head of one of them tongs.
Hey, yeah. What's the target?
Something special. How about having a go at the crown jewels?
Hey, that's a good idea, isn't it? I'll tell you what, we'll go with the main guy.
Sir.
Oh.
See anything there you fancy, sir?
Well, that big one on the right's not bad.
So what I mean is, you seem a fit sort.
Oh.
Ever thought of joining up?
Oh, no, not really. It's not my scene.
I'm sure you'd enjoy life in my regiment, sir.
What regiment's that?
The Queen's.
The Queen's? Oh, I say. Where do I sign? Come on. Oh, I'm going to be one of the professionals.
Say, it's a very kind thought, madam.
Miss.
Miss? But I'm afraid as you're not on the official prison visitors list, you can't come inside.
Oh, but I want to do something for those poor men, especially this cold weather.
And it does you credit, but you don't understand the risks involved. Why, some of these fellows haven't had contact with a woman for 4 or 5 years.
Oh.
And, well, much you quail. I mean, if they was to get hold of you in there, why, you might not come to light for months.
Oh, I'll take a chance. I'll take a chance.
I'm sorry, miss.
We ain't desperate.
Yes, I have my cap on it.
We have a saying here, it's bums that keep chairs, not caps.
That's a lady, if ever I heard one.
Oh, I see we have a southern gentleman honouring us with his presence. Well, don't you come your airs and graces with me. I know all about you Londoners. My first husband was one of them, until I divorced him.
Well, if he was one of them, I'm surprised you married him in the first place. Young lady looks as if she's got her water wings on back to France.
Dirty old beggar.
Hey.
I think it's disgusting the way you men come up here from London with only one thought in your minds, to prey on the flower of northern women and have a bit on the side.
Or on the sands. Yes, well, I must admit the thought did cross my mind as I started off for Blackpool.
Don't tell me it's taken you 40 years to get here.
You know, you must be the rudest, nastiest person I've ever had the misfortune to encounter. There's only one thing I've got to say to you.
And what's that?
Would you like to come and have a drink?
Well, since you twisted me arm.
Yep.
Good morning, sir. Are you the proprietor of this boarding house?
Guest house.
All right, guest house.
I am.
I am from the Weights and Measures, the department that deals with the Trades Descriptions Act.
Oh, yeah.
We note from your advertisement in the holiday guide that this establishment is a mere stone's throw from the sea.
That's right.
May I point out, it has taken me exactly 6.5 minutes hard pedalling to get here from the front.
Hang about.
I'm practically teetotal. Cheers. Well, that's the first 14 pints on you. I think it's about my turn now.
You're a marvel, that's what you are. Where did you learn to drink like that, then?
Well, I'm a very poor swimmer, and I used to play a lot of water polo. Oh, goodbye.
What a magnificent girl that is. A superb specimen.
Yes. That's my wife. We've been married 5.5 months.
I can only say, sir, that you're to be congratulated. She's quite splendid.
Yes, she's not only beautiful, she's loaded. It's worth 500,000.
Good Lord. All that money as well, eh?
That's why I'm killing her.
I beg your pardon?
I said that's why I'm killing her.
But that's monstrous. What are you doing? Poisoning her or something?
Oh, no. Nothing as crude as that. A doctor friend of mine told me how to do it. It only takes 6 months.
How?
I'm loving her to death. Morning, noon and night. I don't give her a minute's peace.
You cunning swine.
So, she's only got 3 weeks to live.
After you, my dear.
Oh, thank you. So this isn't your first visit to Blackpool, then?
Oh, no. We stayed here a few days years ago, when the wife was alive. We stayed at one of them boarding houses. I swore I'd never come back, though.
Why was that?
Well, at the end of the week when the landlady presented the bill, at the bottom it said, Yusuf Cruet, 0.5 crown. I said, what's this? I said, we never used the cruet. She said, well, it was there if you wanted it. So when it came to settling up, I said, I've knocked 30 bob off for your husband's use of my wife. She said, what are you talking about? He never used your wife? I said, well, she was there if he wanted it.
You're asking yourself, how can he knock out a genuine string of pearls for that kind of money? Now, go down to Asprey's in Bond Street and you will see the self-same identical article in the window priced at £250. I am asking a mere £4.50, together with which I will include an 8-day alarm clock and a genuine Joan the Wad for luck. Now,
Jay.
You will notice that we don't... You've done it again, haven't you?
Can I get a football, Dad? And if I don't go now, I'll miss the kicking.
You mean the kick-off?
No, the kicking is outside the ground.
You're not going to any football at all. You're old enough to stop behind here and learn a bit about the business.
Oh, Dad.
I won't be it forever. I mean, I could get took at any time.
Why? Are you ill?
I'm talking about the lawyer, great Burke. Up the stuff here is so hot, it could burn its way through the stall.
Oh, well, if you're going to teach me about thieving, that's different, isn't it?
Yeah. No, that don't come into it. I mean, by the time it reaches here, all the thieving's been already done.
Oh.
What I'm going to do for the humpteenth time is to show you how to flog out the dodgy gear.
Oh.
Now, for instance, there's the Omar Gord routine.
What's that, Dad?
Hang on, I'll... I'll whistle up a mug and give you a demonstration.
Yes.
I say, pardon me, sir. Could I have a word with you, please?
Oh, me?
Yes, sir. You look a generous sort of gentleman. How about taking a little treadmill for the wave?
Not interested.
He's not interested, Dad.
Shut up, you git. How about the genuine Swiss watch, 21 jewels, fully automatic, 18 karat gold?
How much? Nah, 8 quid.
8 quid? Oh, my God! You soppy little twit, you know what you've done?
What have I done, Dad?
You've been to put the wrong price ticket on that watch. I say, I'm awfully sorry, so that should be 38 quid. You silly little...
Hold on. Don't start taking out on the boy. It's your own fault. You're the governor.
I know, Dad, but that's a very, very serious mistake. Don't you realise, under the Sale of Goods Act, I could be forced to sell you that watch for 8 quid?
You could.
Yes, but I mean, fortunately, you don't want it, do you? I mean, you're not interested, are you?
No, let's have another look at it.
Oh.
Not a bad little bargain at that.
Oh, no, play the game, sir. I've got my living to earn. That watch cost me £35.
Yeah, but I'm within my rights, aren't I?
Yeah, well, I tell you what I'll do. I'll give you £5 to just walk away and forget all about it.
You must think I'm a right mug, eh?
Oh, no, sir, no.
Look, it says 8 quid on this ticket. That's just what you're going to get.
No.
Five, six, seven, eight. Not very often we get a chance to put one over on you market grafters, is it?
He's gone, Dad.
That's right, son.
Yeah, I'm sorry about that, Dad. I didn't mean to put the wrong ticket on the watch, Dad. Here, go and hit me, Dad. It don't hurt. Go and hit me. It don't hurt.
No, son, you've done nothing wrong at all.
Oh.
I bought 50 of them watches this morning at 50p each, see?
Oh, you mean you was lying?
That's right.
Hey.
And I want you to do the same.
Oh, great.
Now,
yeah.
I'm going to pop round the boozer for a brown.
Yes,
and when
Dad.
I come back, I want to see that you flogged that watch. Right?
Yes, Dad, yeah.
Now, you remember what your daddy done?
Yeah, I remember what daddy done,
That's
yeah.
That's a good boy.
Oh, excuse me, sir. Could I have a word with you? You look a generous sort of gentleman.
No, not me, son. I'm your father. I haven't gone yet.
Excuse me, sir. Could I have a word with you? You look a generous sort of gentleman.
Are you talking to me, sonny?
Yeah.
Is your eyesight all right?
Oh, I'm so sorry, madam. Hey, do you want to buy your husband a present?
That watch?
Yeah. Yes, that's genuine Swiss 18 carat proof, that is.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Look, have a look at the price. Look at the ticket on it. Go on, have a look at the price. 8 quid! Oh, my God! That's the wrong price. Oh, you soppy little twit. No, I'm a soppy little twit, yeah. That should be 38 quid.
Go on.
Yeah, under the official, what's his name? I have to sell you that at 8 quid, see?
Go away.
Yeah, only if you promise to keep your mouth shut, I'll give you a fiver to go away, here
you are. You will, I'll take it.
Hey, if you're gonna cause trouble, I'll make it a tenner.
End it over, son. There's a good boy.
Yeah.
Will you be here next week?
Yeah, my dad's put me in charge of the store.
I'll tell me friends.
Yeah, all right. Dad, I think I've got it wrong again.
Thank you.
Jack Fairlands.
Cup of tea, love.
Oh, Tom. Ain't it marvellous? When I was doing them on the outside, there was all sorts of bits and pieces on the inside. Now I'm on the inside, there's all sorts of bits and pieces on the outside. I reckon they creep through the glass somehow.
Ta.
Why don't you get a window cleaner?
Round here? They're worth their weight in gold. Funny Dad not coming in for his midday meal, isn't it?
Yeah. Yeah. After the first two or three pints, he's the first one to start banging on a table, isn't he? Did he say where he was going this morning?
I never even saw him leave. All I heard was the door slam. He'd had his breakfast as usual. The postman came. I went upstairs to see to the twins. Next thing I knew, he'd gone.
Hmm? Bit of luck he's eloped with that old bird on the lamp bulbs at wars.
Well, if he wants his lamb chops dried to a chip, that's his lookout.
What's that?
Rita, what on earth are you doing rushing through my kitchen?
Mr. Lampwick asked me to come through and open the front door for him. He gave me a quid for doing it.
A quid? For opening the door? That'll be the day.
Oh. Afternoon, Lily. Afternoon, Ernie. All right, Henry, you can bring the stuff in now.
Sir?
Shove them all down there, will you?
Certainly, sir.
Lily.
Right.
I'm having hallucinations, darling.
Thank you for the pound, Mr. Lampwick.
That's all right, my love. You keep it. Listen, here's a fiver. You nip down to the sweet shop on the corner and buy sweets for all the children in the street.
Oh, thank you.
All
Dad,
right.
Hey, is that you?
Yeah, all right, Henry, you can go now.
Very good, sir.
Well, what are you two standing there with your mouths hanging open like codfish for? You surprised at something?
Surprised?
Yes.
I'm flaming flabbergasted.
Yes.
Whose body are you wearing?
Well, if you're referring to the gear, it's the best that King's Road Chelsea could supply.
But, Dad, you're a lot taller than when you got up this morning.
Ah, yes, you see, that's because me Rod Stewart walked tall, you see.
You know, I don't understand it. You look diabolical, but it must have cost you a fortune.
Well, you're entitled to your opinion, but I consider that this ensemble is entirely suitable for a man of substance like myself.
Dad, where did you get the money?
I'm sorry I rushed out this morning, love, but I had to get some shopping done. But I haven't forgotten my lovely daughter. There you are, dear. Or a layabout husband.
Thank you.
Oh, please God, it's not real.
Well, if it isn't, I want my 1,500 quid back.
Here, look, Lil. Look at this lovely watch. I've seen these advertised in the paper. Is it about 800 quid?
832 with VAT. I left the ticket on it so you could flash it in the pub. That's what I should be doing with mine, you see.
Dad, where did you get the money?
Oh, and I've also got something to keep you nice and warm when you're hanging out the washing, love.
It's mink. Right. It's mink. And it's real.
All right, darling. Don't upset yourself. I've just tumbled. Now, the postman came this morning, didn't he?
Yes.
And then he rushed out, right? You've come up with the pools, haven't you? Yes, you have.
No,
you've
I haven't.
Come up with
no,
the pools.
I haven't. I don't go in for vulgar things like common gambling. Oh, by the way, Lily, I've bought the twins one or two bits and pieces, and if you'd care to look out of the window, you might see something that'll amuse you.
Oh, my God.
It's a Rolls Royce, isn't it?
That's right.
You're going to tell me you bought that and all?
No, it's on hire. 100 quid a day with the chauffeur. But if I like it, I might buy a couple.
Dad.
Yes?
Just, sit down, will you?
Yes, certainly, yes. Right.
Now, I'm going to ask you one last and final time.
Yes?
Where did you get the money?
From the bank.
He's robbed a bank.
Don't be daft. He couldn't rob a bank. How did you do it?
Well, I'm surprised that you should think that I would do anything illegal. No, you see, this is the bank statement that arrived first post this morning. Yeah.
Lily,
be. It says here £82,410 in credit.
Yes. Less the few bits and pieces I spent this morning, yes.
Which brings me back to the original question. Where did you get the money?
Well, I suppose it must be a legacy from the people whose lives I saved during the First World War. They always said they'd remember me in their wills.
Now, we know you're a senile old goat, but even you don't believe that. I know what it is. It's a mistake.
You mean it's not his money?
No, it's them flaming computers. They're always making mistakes like that.
Don't be ridiculous.
All right, then, mate. Take last month's bank statement. How much was in it then?
£82.
What do you reckon the rest is? Interest?
I don't care. What can't speak can't lie. It says it's in there and I'm going to spend it.
They'll send him to prison, that's what they'll do.
Well, it's an ill wind, isn't it? I've got a lovely watch, you've got a nice mink stole, and he's in prison. Everything in the garden's lovely, isn't it?
You ungrateful RAF poofter. Oh, by the way, Lily, I sent a telegram putting the twins' name down for Eton.
Have you forgotten that one of them's a girl?
Well, don't matter, do her good. Oh, that must be the new bedroom suite arrived.
Well, if it is, it's going straight back, I can tell you that.
You'll never get away with it, Dad. But I don't blame you for having a go, mate.
Your bank manager to see you, Dad.
Hello, Mr. Purslow.
All right, Mr. Lambrick. I think you know why I'm here. Passing fraudulent checks is a very serious offence.
Here. Don't you start chucking accusations about, mate. That came from your bank.
Yes. Well, but I mean, it's obvious nonsense. He couldn't possibly have believed that.
Oh, but I did. I always believe the statements you send me.
And why shouldn't he? Banks aren't supposed to make mistakes.
Well, nobody's perfect.
Well, how come the shops took his cheque? I mean, look at him.
I showed them the statement, then told them to ring up the bank.
Yes. And one of my assistants looked up his account and found that figure. Blasted computers.
There you are, then. It's 90% your fault, mate.
Well, very well. I'll accept the blame. But, I'll also have to take the goods back.
Aye.
Martin, and you.
Will that be an order, sir?
Well, you'd ask him. You're working for me now. Thank you.
Oh, there you are.
Thank you. Please. Thank
you. Lily.
Well, I suppose you'll be wanting the gear back then.
No, I think not. I'll raise a few people's bank charges to pay for that. One more thing before I go, Mr. Lambrick. Until the computer is adjusted, your checkbook, please.
Oh. There you are.
Thank you. Good morning.
Oh, well, thank goodness that's over.
But it was marvellous while it lasted.
But it had to stop, and it...
Never mind. All is not lost. Here's the Green Shield stamps on 5,000. Boys, Mr. Capone lives next door. The roof of today.
Can I squeeze in?
Oh, certainly.
Room for a little one, is there?
All right, all aboard! Take it away, Charlie. Right. Boop! Giddly-dum.
Giddle-dee, giddle-dee-da. Giddle-dee-da, giddle-dee, giddle-dee-da. Giddle-dee-do, giddle-dee, giddle-dee-da, giddle-dee-da, giddle-dee. Those are the days.
Pardon?
Steam. Kings of the Iron Road. Comparing diesel to steam is like comparing Twiggy to Mae West.
Really?
Yeah, I do them all, you know. Shunting. Yeah. Ba-ding, ding, 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 bing, bing, ding, 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 ding. Ba-ding, ding, ding, ba-ding, bing, bing, ding, 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 ding.
Very good.
Very good. You close your eyes, you're there. Yeah, now look. Train going over points, all right? Giddle-dee, giddle-dee-da. Diddly-dee, well, go on, close your eyes. We're off train going under a bridge at 60 miles an hour, right? Giddly-dee, giddly-da, giddly-dee, giddly-da, giddly-dee, giddly-dee. That's good, isn't it, eh? Here, remember this one? First, please. Ching.
On a train?
Well, now we're being silly, aren't we? Bus conductor. You know, separate tickets in the holder. Ticket in the machine, you know, in the clipper. Ching!
Yes, a bit before my time.
Lee Wolf. Put that light out! This is Fump speaking. Charmony calling. Charmony calling. Hey, hey, hey. Then there was old Nasty himself. Kiss out! Kiss out, Pepe! He didn't, couldn't, pass and didn't! Come out, saloon! Kiss out of Julius Miller! I swear to have a telephone!
A German station announcer.
That's very good. They broke the mold when they made you, didn't they, eh?
Old Man River, that Old Man River, he must know something, but don't say nothing. He just keeps rolling, he just keeps rolling along.
Paul Robson, showboat.
You like transport, don't you?
Oh, do them all, do them all.
A handbag.
I'll
do it again for you.
A handbag.
Lady Cracknell, importance of being earnest. Oscar Wilde. He may have been a bit of a Jesse, but he could write like a good un.
Oh, yes.
Oh, yeah. Lighthouse. He's a good one. I've had a terrible cold lately.
Big old partner, I really must be going.
What train?
Doncaster.
Late. Points blew up at Peterborough. Hit! 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 Better with two spoons, though. Needs must when the devil drives.
Of course.
We are not amused. We are not amused. We were only saying to John Brown early this morning, we are not amused by the decline in the manners and courtesy of our subjects. Their conduct is most unseemly. That is exactly what we are referring to. How dare you rise before your sovereign gives you leave to do so? Be seated, sir.
You are stark raving mad. You should be locked up.
Sit down. We are about to board our train and would command you to show due deference as we do so.
It's a potty. He shouldn't be allowed out. He... Who are you?
I'm the station master.
What was all that then?
That was my tea break.
You've got this straight, haven't you?
Yes, Dad.
Well, we've got to cop this 100-acre prize, right?
Right, Dad.
Right. Now, my line will be the one with this big red float on it.
Yeah. You're not clever, Dad.
Just runs in the family, son. Runs in the family.
Yeah.
Now, there's the money.
Dad.
Now, off you go. Down to the fishmongers.
Right, Dad.
Give me that, you little twit. I need that. Ah, bless you. Molly?
Morning.
Good morning.
Hello.
Ah, quite a nice day for fishing, isn't it? Oh, that's good. That is very good.
Every little helps.
Oh, I've got a big one. Oh, God blimey, it's lively. This is a winner. This is a winner. Well, it's unprecedented, I must admit, but life is unusual. Yes, it's unusual. Life is, I don't know. Just a minute, fellas. No, you can't do that. No, just a moment.
Dad? I think I got it wrong again.
Yes, my dear.
This is Raymond, one of my teaching colleagues from school.
Hello, young man.
So you're Clarissa's young friend.
Yes, sir. How do you do, sir?
Oh, how do you do? Do sit down. We're just about to have some tea.
Thank you, sir.
Yes. I gather that, Tom, you teach English at St. Gregory's.
Yes, that's correct, sir.
Jolly good. Thank you, my dear. Well, I expect you'd like something to eat. What's in that dish there?
Crumpet, sir.
I beg your pardon.
I said crumpet, sir.
A word in your ear. I would appreciate it if you wouldn't use such language in front of my daughter.
But, sir, I only said crumpets.
Only? Perhaps you're unaware that the word has prurient connotations.
But it's the normal name for crumpets.
Not in this house. My daughter Clarissa is as pure in mind as she is in body. The word, and it is my intention that she remain so. The word in this house for those comestibles is dibble.
Dibble.
A word of my own contrivance.
But surely you know that dibble is a slang word for...
Enough said. Please come and sit down. A dibble, Raymond.
Oh, thank you, sir.
Tea, Daddy?
Thank you, my dear.
Mmm. Excellent dibbles, Clarissa. And followed, if my eyes don't deceive me, by minced tarts.
Are you having a joke with me, young man?
No, sir, of course not. There's nothing wrong with saying minced.
The word in this house is placket. Minced placket.
But, sir, placket is an 18th century word.
Let
but...
us say no more. Kindly watch your language in future.
Yes, sir. I'm so sorry, sir.
Have a mince a placket, Raymond.
Oh, thank you, sir. They look almost as good as the dibbles.
Yes, dear boy?
Oh, well, I was just admiring the room.
Yes, it is pleasant, isn't it? My daughter, Clarissa, has made it most attractive since we've been here.
Oh, very nice. Well done, Clarissa. That's a lovely big chest you've got there.
The word is pizzle. Yes, it is a lovely old oak pizzle, isn't it?
Terribly sorry, I can't apologise enough. Terribly silly, I mean, I keep coming out with these awful boobs.
Strunts! Strunts! Well, no doubt you'll be wanting to get back to the school to catch up on some of your markings, perhaps.
No, sir, I'm not going back to the school this evening. I've decided to have it off with Clarissa.
You have gone too far. Much too far. Clarissa, Clarissa, go and make some more tea at once. What are you trying to do? What is the purpose of these disgusting innuendos?
But, sir, honestly, I...
Is it an attempt to pervert and corrupt my daughter with modern filth?
No, sir, of course not. I wouldn't dream of it.
I mean, ever since you've been in this house, you've been using the most absolutely appalling language.
No, I haven't, sir, truly. No, it's those words you've been using, sir. They're far worse.
What on earth do you mean?
Well, sir, I've made a bit of a study of 17th and 18th century slang, sir.
Yeah.
And, well, Dibble, for instance, means... Blacket is an 18th century word for... Whereas pizzle is slang for...
What about strunts?
Ah, now, strunt, according to every authority I've ever come across, is an exceedingly vulgar word for...
Disgusting. Young man, this is a vicarage, not a barrack room. I am appalled, yes, appalled by your language.
No, it's not my language, sir,
Daddy,
honestly.
I've brought some more dibbles.
Oh, not you too, Clarissa, dear. Oh, it's more than the human frame can bear. Go and wash your mouth out before it gets polluted forever.
But Daddy, a dibble is...
I know what a dibble is, thank you. And I hope and pray that you at least will never find out. Well, not until you're married. Filthy obscenity.
Obscenity? But it wasn't obscene 2 minutes ago.
It is now. I'm utterly shocked at the language that young people use these days. Have you no decency, no decorum? Oh, the strain is too much. I shall have to go and lie down.
I'm so sorry about Daddy Raymond. He does sometimes get rather upset.
Yes.
But when you get to know him, you know he's really quite an amiable old sod.
Good morning.
Morning.
Mr. Roberts?
That's right.
I'm the examiner for your driving test, so let's start straight away with the eye test. Can you tell me the number of that car over there?
What car?
The one over there, by the office block.
What office block?
Is there something wrong with your eyes?
Who said that? Oh, see, oh, there you are. I didn't see you standing there.
Shouldn't you be wearing glasses?
Oh, I had a pair once. I put them down somewhere. I haven't been able to find them since.
Such bad eyesight. How do you manage in your driving lessons?
Oh, quite well, considering. Of my 42 accidents, only 36 involved serious injury.
How many lessons did you have?
Oh, just the one. My instructor must have thought I was quite good because he told me not to bother taking any more lessons with me.
I'm sorry, Mr. Roberts, but I've got some bad news for you.
Really? What's that?
I'm afraid I must fail you. Your eyesight is so bad, you'd be in obvious danger to other road users.
Oh, dear. That means I'll be the only brain surgeon at the hospital without a car.
Second Lieutenant Ponsonby reporting for duty, sir.
Yes. Stand easy. Ponsonby. I believe I knew your sister, Penelope. How is she?
In bed with cramp at present, sir.
Oh, would that be young cramp of the household cavalry? Oh, never mind.
No, sir.
Oh, my dear chap, loosen up a bit and stop saluting all the time. You might hurt someone. We don't go in for much formality in the regiment. What's your first name? My name's Freddie.
Timothy, sir. Freddie.
That's more like it. Now, come along, I'll introduce you to the CO. His name's Peter.
Freddie, could I ask you something?
Certainly, Timothy.
What do you call your privates?
Tom, Dick and Harry, what do you call yours?
Ah, come in. Mr. and Mrs. Jones, isn't it?
Yes.
Do take a seat, will you?
Oh, thank you. This is your, first time, is it? Yes.
Oh, excuse me a moment. Hello. Oh, blimey, not you again. How many times have I told you not to ring me up at work, you stupid old bag? I'll shout if I want to! What? Oh, you will you? Well, you just try. Up yours as well! Well, you do, and I'll tell everybody how you got that splinter in your backside. Well, go back to your flaming mother, then! Bitch! Now, you were saying?
That wasn't your wife on the telephone, was it?
Yes, that was the little lady, yeah. Excuse me once again.
You don't seem to get on too well together.
Well, I mean, how can I, as a marriage guidance counsellor, hope to solve any of your problems if I don't have the odd little tiff now and again?
I never thought about it that way.
That's right. So, what's your problem?
Ah, well, Millie and I, we're considering a divorce. You see, I don't love her anymore.
She's not up to much, is she? I mean, there's not much chance of you being unfaithful, is there? Except when it's foggy.
Pardon?
Well, I mean, she's a bit off, isn't she? A bit gorgonzola. God, what a mess. Do you mean to say that you walked here with that on your arm through the streets in broad daylight?
Why not?
They say chivalry's dead.
She's not all that bad.
Oh, not if you go in for the warthog look, no.
It This is my wife you're talking about.
Yes. Excuse me a moment. Oh, that's better. You were saying?
You bounder! Now, look, as you've done, you started to cry.
Well, don't worry. When the tears see that fizzog, they'll probably turn back.
I've a good mind to punch you on the nose.
I tell you what, why don't you really make me suffer? Why don't you get her to strip off?
Right, now, you ask for this. Oh. Come on, Millie.
Oh, Percy. You defended my honour.
Yes, I did.
That must mean you still love me.
Yes, I suppose it does. Kiss.
Kiss.
Next.
Ladies tights, 20p a pair. Here you are, girls. Get your tights here. Best quality, 20p. 20p only for these marvellous ladies' tights.
Ladies' tights, 20p a pair. Ladies' tights, 20p a pair.
Bargain offer, 18p a pair for these lovely ladies' tights.
Here, here. Ladies' tights with 15p.
18p a pair only.
Here, 15p a pair, ladies' tights, 15p a pair.
Sacrificial offer, 12p for these beautiful ladies' tights. 12p only for ladies' tights.
10p, ladies' tights. 10p a pair, ladies' tights.
8p a pair for these lovely ladies' tights. An absolute bargain. Fabulous ladies' tights. 8p only for these ladies' tights.
4p, 4p a pair, ladies' tights. Here, 4p a pair.
You've done me, lad.
Yeah?
4p a pair, I can't be there. How many pair you got there? 50?
Yeah, that's right.
Here you are then. That's seven.
Hey, I've sold out.
Yeah. You're mad, ain't you?
Yeah.
Ladies' tights, 20p a pair. It's lovely ladies' tights, only 20p a pair. Come on, ladies. That's all I'm asking. 20p, the micromix.
Hey, Dad. I've got it wrong again.
Where you'll find they're well worth the money. There you are.
Oh, it must be some months since I've been down in your basement, Bert. And I'm curious to know what you have done with it this time.
Well, have a look for yourself, Walt. I think it's fairly obvious.
You've led it to the corporation for a rubbish dump.
I have turned it into a film studio.
My word, Bert. If you are going to make films, then that Alfred Hotchkick will have to look up his laurels, won't he?
Sensibly observed, old friend. No, I intend to lead a crusade against the tide of blue, pornographic, dirty films what is sweeping the country.
That is quite commendable, Bird. I might add, I have seen hundreds of them, and each one is worse than the last.
You are to be congratulated, Wong. You must have seen nearly as many as that Lord Longford.
Tell me, how many great picture films have you on your schedule this year, sir?
Well, I've got one or two epics in the scenario stage. For instance, there's a four-hour biblical mammoth that I intend to start shooting next Saturday afternoon.
And when will that be completed?
Sunday afternoon. Guess who's going to be my leading man?
Don't tell me. Charlton Heston.
Yes, I did consider it. But on reflection, he's got one big drawback.
What's that, Bert?
He's too tall for the costumes.
Oh, then who is going to be the fortunate performer?
Why, you are, me old lad.
I am deeply and sincerely flattered, Bert. And as it is a biblical picture, I shall inform the Ealing Herald that Sophia Loren and I are just good friends.
I hope you're not going to be one of them temperamental stars.
Oh, I see you have lots and lots of equipment in your studio, Bert.
Yes, I wondered when you were going to notice it. Come over here and I'll show you the camera. There we are. Made with these two hands, naturally.
I wouldn't have thought otherwise. I see it is made of wood.
True, but electrically operated. I think I can safely say that that's the only camera in the world that is run on a food mixer. I'll show you how it works.
Hey, Bert.
Yeah? Now I'm focusing. Hang on, I'm trying to focus.
Bert!
Yes. Oh, it's a lovely clear picture now. Oh, there's only one problem. I seem to have run out of film.
Yes, you have, Bert. It's all run out on the floor.
I didn't bring you down here to criticise, you know.
I beg your pardon, Bert.
Granted, old friend. Now, here you will see the essence of my intentions. Think clean, no filth.
And quite right, too.
Now, in my next picture, I intend to embody the wholesome schoolboy story with the magic of science fiction and the excitement of the Western.
And what are you going to call it, Bert?
Billy Bunter meets kindly sexless monster at the OK Corral.
Oh, I suppose that is the Western Saloon bar there.
Yes, this is we're going to have the big fight, yeah? And these are the bottles they hit each other over the head with.
But they are milk bottles, Bert.
I won't have any boozing in my films, lad. Of course, these bottles are not real, you know. They don't hurt. Look, I'll show you.
That's amazing, that is.
Yes. Go on, you have a go.
Here you go.
That must be the one I brought down for our tea. Now, let me show you another bit of movie magic. Have you ever wondered when we shoot a man how the blood pours out and it doesn't seem to hurt him?
Yes, I do find that extremely mystifying, Bert.
Well, now, I'll show you how it works, Walt. Take off your coat, lad. There we are. Now, slip that in your shirt pocket there. There we are. Right?
Yes.
Now, when I say action, I want you to go like this. Oh! Like that, right?
Like this!
Oh, yes, that's very clever, that is. You're bleeding to death and I haven't shot you yet. Come on, let's have a shootout. When I count to three, you fire.
Hey, Bert.
Yeah?
If it's all the same to you, I'd like to be John Wayne.
Well, it's not all the same to me. These are my guns and I want to be John Wayne. You can be Bert Lancaster.
Right, I like Bert Lancaster.
All right, then be John Wayne, only let's get on with it. Now, when I count to three, you ready?
Yes.
One, two. I see the Carters have got their new deep freeze. By the way, I haven't shown you the special effects department, have I?
No, you haven't, Bert.
Ah, well, come over here, lad. Now, this is where I intend to shoot the remake of Nanook of the North. You haven't had your screen test yet, have you?
No, Bert.
Well, go behind that iceberg there and I'll get the equipment out, all right? Now, just get this machine into position here.
Are you, Bert?
No, I'm not going to fire any guns, just a blizzard. I'm just getting the wind machine ready and getting the snow ready.
Oh,
now,
Bert.
When I say action, I want you to come out. When you start acting, Remember, it's 30 below, and you're facing a false 10. Right, now, just wind it up. Right, you ready?
Yes!
Right, action! Action! I told you, no filth. If you want to make sexy films, you go to another studio.
Oh, I'm sorry, Bert.
All right. Here. Put this on. I don't want any flashing in my studio. Here, I'll give us the goggles. Here you are. Stick your arm through.
Yes.
Cut your arm through there?
Yes.
That's right. That's right. Oh, that's not bad. Hang on a moment. Yes, that's very good. It's marvellous, that is. Hang on a moment. I'm going to have you in my next epic.
Yes, and I shall be pleased to accept that, so long as you don't shoot me in a blizzard.
No, 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 lad. This is a classic. This is about the face that launched 1,000 ships. Helen of Troy.
It sounds fascinating, Bert. What will you call it?
If at first you don't succeed, Troy, Troy again.
I see you have developed a hair trigger sense of humour, Bert.
That was not meant to be funny.
Sorry, Bert.
Well, now, as we've got the costume on, we may as well start filming, eh?
Yes.
You get rid of that snow machine, and I'll go and fetch it.
Fetch what, Bert?
You'll soon see, lad. You'll soon see.
My God, Bert, what is it?
That is the Trojan horse, lad. I'm going to use that in the climax of my film. There's a door at the back and 100 soldiers come out.
How are you going to do that, Bert?
It'll be you coming out 100 times wearing a different hat. Just think of it, Bert. There's his Trojan horse outside the gates of Troy. It's dawn, and there's a sound of a distant bugle. Hang on.
I'm sorry about the horse, Bert. Was it the music made him do that?
No, it was my fault, actually. I was saving this to blow down the walls of Jericho. Never mind. Come up to the attic. I want you to see a cartoon film what I'm painting. Come on, man. Put some milk in.
Action, Emery.
Oh, Miss Selkin.
Yes?
You tripped over the wire.
Who's in one, take one?
Stand by at the back there, John. Action, Dick.
Good old Miss Selkin. She's done us proud. Right you are, Bob. I reckon you should change the title to Richard the Third.
What's wrong with the title I've got?
Well, who's ever heard of a play called Richard the 11th?
I'll take that.
Right. Yeah. No, 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 no. That's a sample. That's a sample. Hang on, I'll get you one. I can't find a bloody feather.
71, take one.
Quick one, Bizen. Action, Dick.
When you've had a drink of your milk or water, no harm can come to you.
Well, what exactly happened, Sergeant Major?
Well, I took him on a tour of inspection, sir, around the building section.
Yeah, I didn't know he had one.
Oh, yes. Anyway, it was there that Mr. Mean had his unfortunate accident.
Accident?
Yes, sir. He slipped.
In Germany is waiting for me a dreadful fate.
Oh, the war, you mean?
My wife, I mean. So what? I went up in Jewishness.
I'll not permit you to stagger all that way. Take my car.
God bless you, sir.
Hello.
I thought you were cooking something.
Good shot, old boy.
What's that of?
Turn round. What?
Action.
What I'm really looking for, Di, is some sort of concealed weapon.
Oh, I've got just the very thing. That's a genius on my part. Do I say it? I shouldn't.
He moves moustache. Moves moustache.
How would you like a fountain pen that converts to a rapid-fire, high-velocity, belt-fed machine gun?
Sounds fantastic. Looks just like an ordinary fountain pen, does it?
I've got one right here in my pocket.
Right. Seize him, lads.
You see, you're supposed to say, went to sea in a beautiful pea-green boat.
Why?
Because that's what this week's written.